Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, and Peter went out and wept bitterly. And Peter said, Man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately while he yet spake, the cock crew. And the Lord turned and looked upon Peter. And Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said unto him, Before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. And Peter went out and wept bitterly. Luke 22:60-62. Wept means to sob, wail. Bitterly means violently. What would cause a person to behave in this manner? What would cause a person to sob in the presence of God? What would cause them to wail in repentance, weeping bitterly for forgiveness? Peter realized that he had done wrong. He came to the realization that he had sinned against God. Judas also came to the realization that night, but could not find it in himself to repent. So the Bible tells us that he went out and hung himself. Romans 3:23 let us know that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Who has? All. Everybody. Every one of us here today, at some point in our lives, we have denied the relationship with him. Here was a strong man, a fisherman by trade. Many storms he weathered out in the sea. Here was someone who would fight to defend Jesus, but we find him weeping bitterly. Could it be that he realized how much Jesus loved him? Could it be that he realized that when no one cared, Jesus cared for him? Could it be that he had realized that he had denied his greatest friend? Well, let me tell you why Peter wept bitterly. Jesus had told him in Matthew 10:33, But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. He had denied Jesus 3 times in one night. Peter realized that there was no way in the world he could get into heaven now. He sealed his own faith. He shut the door of heaven on himself. He denied the Savior of the world 3 times. No one held a sword to his throat and made him say it. He did it on his own, of his own choice. How many remember that Jesus had given Peter the keys of the kingdom? I want to use just a little bit of liberty and suggest to you that if Peter didn't get things right with God that night, none of us would have had the chance to get into heaven. We don't realize the effect we have on other people around us. We don't realize that their salvation depends on our salvation. They won't follow Christ if they don't have an example. When Peter looked up after he had denied Jesus for the 3rd time, I believe he saw more than the displeasure that was on Jesus' face. I believe he saw the anger of God. I believe he saw the kind of look that our parents would give us to let you know that you really messed up. I believe Peter wept because he realized that his laziness towards the things of God had gone too far. That's why the tears, that's why the weeping. He knew that he did wrong, and he knows that if he repents, God will forgive him. 1 John 1:9-10 reminds us, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from our unrighteousness. I wonder if there's one person listening right now who would confess your faults to God and make it right with him. You might think by holding it in, everything will be okay. But by holding it in, you offend God. The thought of the day. I believe Peter wept because he realized that his laziness towards the things of God had gone too far. God bless you today. In Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.